Hello friends, welcome to our Let's Flavors YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see a most widely used command line tool called Nmap. It is a short form of network mapper. Nmap is an open source tool used for network scanning and auditing purpose. There is a lot of useful options available for this command line tool. For the sake of this video, here we are going to see some of its useful options. Network mapper, commonly used for security audit for multiple systems, monitoring host or services uptime. We can find state of a particular port in a particular host machine. We can find which operating system is running on a remote machine. We can find how our system was secure from attackers. We can test the target host is up or not. For this demo, I am using CentOS 6.5 operating system. For Nmap command, we have to install the package Nmap. Before that, I am going to test the internet connectivity. Pinging the public IP of Google IP address, ping 8.8.8.8. It's pinging properly. Using yum package manager, you can install the software like this wise. Yum install nmap-y. Here you can see already some of our process is holding the yum service. So I want to remove that service and then start the installation. The PID holding location is var ran yum.pid. This is a location. You can see this PID here. I want to remove this and restart the installation. Now the installation is doing properly. You can see the installation is completed here. This is a man page of Nmap command. Here you can see the description. Nmap is a network mapper, is an open source tool for network exploration and security auditing purpose. We can scan a large network. Not only the large network, we can scan the single host also using this Nmap command. And we can find out what operating system is running on a remote machine. Using its OS version also we can see. After seeing the man page, we can test some of its options and command how we are going to use this command in our day-to-day system activities. Normally we are using ping command to test the connectivity of a remote machine. Here likewise we can use this Nmap command also using nmap-sn using its public IP address and try to test that connectivity. Here you can see the result of this 8.8.8.8 public IP address of a Google server. The system host is upstate. It scanned in 0.11 seconds and you can find out the reverse DNS of this public IP address. So I can test my local router's IP address also like this wise. Nmap-sn192.168.0.1. This is my local router IP address. Here you can see it's taking a lot of time because the RDNS is still not resolved for this IP. So it will take some time. Here you can see the MAC address of the IP address. It is a router IP address, so it cannot have any RDNS. We can test the another one IP address. If the IP address is still not available right now, it's not pinging. Here you can see the result of what a result it will show. This is unknown IP address. Here it's showing the host seems down. IP address blocked by a firewall of the remote machines. I think the system is on upstate, but the firewall is blocking our scanning connectivity test. One thing you have to know before using this command, if you are scanning any remote machine, that remote machine firewall should know about what you are doing in these machines. So every scanning process is auditing by the remote machine. So before using this command, please be careful in any public manner. The second option is Nmap without giving any option and paste the IP address. Here you can see the result of a top opening ports of this machine. Here port number 22 is an SSH port if the state is in open, and port number 53 is also an open state. It's a DNS resolver port. And port number 5901, it's a VNC port, it's also in open state. And then you can notice there is 997 ports are closed in this IP address machine. And then here you notice the reverse DNS of this public IP address. The third option is nmap-a. -a, it means it will print all the details about this machine. Here you can see the port numbers and its states and its service and its version also it's showing. Here you can see the SSH version is OpenSSH 7 point something and the domain name system is Microtik Routers OS name system and VNC version protocol is 3.8 also it is showing. and then you can see the trace through path of this machine also, and it will show which operating system is running on this machine. And then the fourth option is Nmap hyphen hyphen top ports, and then you will give any numbers. That means you can, here I will mention 10, you can print any numbers here, and it will print the top ports of this machine. Here you can see this machine having a port number 21. Already show this port number 21 is a FTP, it's on closed state. Only SSH connection is on open state. Rest of that, all the ports are in closed state only. SMTP, HTTP, POP3, all these ports are in closed state only. Like this wise, we can give any numbers on Nmap command with top ports option. The next option is Nmap-P. That means it's specify particular port and we can find out the status of a remote machine ports. Here I will mention Nmap-P80. 80 is a default port of the HTTP. And the status of this port is in closed state. Already we noticed on previous result also. Likewise, we can test any ports using this command nmap-p and specify the port number. I am using another one port number also, 9393. This is I think this is not any default port for any service, but it's also printing the result that is on closed state. It's the service is on unknown. And another one thing, you can specify the protocol of this port. You can, if it is a TCP protocol, you can print capital T colon 9363. Likewise, you can print the, it's a UDP or TCP ports also, it will print the result. And another useful option is if you want to scan an entire network or if you want to scan a multiple system, you can also use this command nmap-a and specify all the host IP address or IP range. You can print and then try the scanning results also. Here the list of the previous command, it will print all the status of a remote port, remote IP's port numbers. 118 port is on open state, port number service is POP3, and port number 143 is a IMAP protocol, it is on open state. Likewise, we can, here you can see, likewise we can test all this port numbers status of a remote machine. Not only single machine, we can test the connectivity of multiple machines also, but the second machine downstate only. Here you can see two IP addresses NMAP done, but one host is on upstate and another host is on downstate. It will print the result clearly. It's showing zero hops network distance because it is a local IP address of this machine only. So it's showing, it does not show any trace route path. And another useful option is if you want print the open ports only on a remote machine, you can use this option nmap-open and then the remote machine's IP address. It will print only the open ports of the remote machine, not all the port numbers and its status. Here you can see this, it will print only four ports are in open state on this machine. So friends, please be careful. Anyone can scan our machine using this nmap command. This is only for a security purpose only using this command. For example, I want to change a port number of a SSH service from default port number 22 into 9363 and then start the SSH service in this machine. Here you can notice that SSH port number, default port number is not listed in this nmap scanning process because it does not, it will scan the top ports only. So if you want to specify a particular port and scan the result, it will never print the service of the particular port number because the default port number was changed. So most of the service you have to change the default port number and then make your service and make your system more secure from remote attackers. Lot of another useful command line options also available for this nmap command. Using man page, you can find out all those options, and they have mentioned a detailed explanation in an example also how to use this command, how to test the connectivity of a remote machines. Everything I have mentioned clearly in this man page, you can read it clear and use it in your day-to-day system activities task. So friends, I think this video is more useful for you. Please, if you have any suggestion, comment in the comment section. I will do further. If you have any corrections also, please mention in the comment section. And then finally, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching, friends.